Hello everyone, and welcome to this mini tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to recreate this animation using Linearity Move. Let's create a new file. Go to File, click New. We're going to set a custom resolution. Click on the drop-down menu and select Custom. Now input the following numbers: 1080 pixels for the width, 1350 pixels for the height, and let's leave the frame rate as 30 fps. Click confirm. We're going to import our design, so go to new scene and select import. Select the file provided called onlineAd.curve. Click open. In the import panel, you will see as many artboards as there are on your curve file, which in this case is just one. Select the artboards and drag and drop it onto the scene builder line. Click import. Now we've created the first scene. Double click the scene to enter the timeline. On the left, in the layer panel, you will see all the layers that are composing our design. Let's start animate. First, we're going to animate the image at the center of our design. Go onto the timeline and zoom in a little bit. Move the playhead to second number 1 and hit K on the keyboard. This will freeze all the properties of our elements in time at this moment on the timeline. Select the image, take the playhead back to second 0, and then use the bounding boxes to resize the image. Hold Shift and Option while you do so, so the image will resize proportionally from the center. Drag the image until it covers the canvas. Now it's time to animate the text. Select the first text one. Tilt it of 5 degrees. And then drag it outside the boundaries of the canvas. Hold Shift while you drag it upward, so it will move on a straight line. Do the same for text number 2. Tilt it of 5 degrees, and then drag it down holding Shift. Now we're going to animate the star using presets. You can find presets here on the left in your working space. Select the star, and use the preset Fade In and Scale In. By selecting these two presets, we just added a size animation and an opacity animation. Here's the preview. We're also going to add a preset animation to text number 3, and we're just going to add Fade In. We need to add another animation to the star, which is Rotation. Use the bounding box to rotate the star. By clicking on this handle, you can just rotate it as much as you want. Roughly 90 degrees will work. We want the rotation to keep going for as long as the animation. So let's grab the last keyframe and drag it till the end of the animation. We're also going to change the animation ease by clicking the animation bar, going to the animation tab on the right, and select timing linear. Let's preview our animation so far. Perfect. Now it's time to animate the background. Bring the playhead back to 0 and zoom in onto the canvas a bit more. Here in the layer panel, you will see the 3 text layers, which are now covered by the image, but don't worry, we don't need to see them to do this animation. Click on the first text and bring the playhead to the first bar. Then go to Style, and we're going to change the property called Fill. You don't want to disable the fill, you just want to lower its opacity. So go here and put it to 0%. Then bring the playhead to second number 1 and copy and paste the first keyframe. Command C to copy, Command V to paste. This way we've created our transition from 100% to 0% to 100% again. Click and drag to select the animation bars, and then Command C to copy and Command V to paste. Do it until the end of the animation. You will notice that the animation is happening very slowly from one state to the other. This is a fade animation, but we want it to be sudden. So to change that, select the animation bar. Go to the animation panel, and here in the timing, we're going to change it from natural to step. Do that for every segment. And let's preview the animation. It's working. Now we just have to copy and paste this entire animation line to the next text. Command C to copy, bring the playhead to second zero, select the next text, and Command V to paste. And do the same for the last one, Command V to paste. Now if you preview the animation, you will see coming and going at the same time, but we want them to be scattered. So to do that, we're going to select the second line of text in this group called text 5, and we're going to drag and move the bar until the second stage aligns with the first one. Open the dropdown to tidy up the keyframes. And you notice that one keyframe is missing at the end, so we're going to copy the second to last, Command C, and paste it, Command V. Let's preview the animation now. And it's working. Now let's go to File, Export, and don't forget to share your results with us. Thank you for joining me today. See you in the next tutorial.